Very dry air across much of the Gulf of Mexico, and that is probably going to help keep Eta off to our east. We're watching that front to bring us some drier air, but also that is really going to act as more of a shield to keep Eta away from us. As I mentioned, the coldest of the air is staying up to our north. We're going to get into more of a drier air mass that really will be kind of lagging behind the front and won't really arrive until more Wednesday night and into Thursday. But that energy is going to keep Eta away from us because it does look like Eta is going to be a stronger storm, so feeling more of the influences of the upper levels, which should keep it well away from us. And that has been the change that we have consistently seen since earlier this morning. Eta is getting stronger. Winds now of 65 miles an hour, and there has definitely been a concentrated area of thunderstorms that has been constantly going. And the Hurricane Center is even mentioning that at kind of these in between times, we may see Eta briefly become a hurricane before weakening. But there has been another dramatic shift in the forecast. Now we're looking at a landfall north of Tampa by late Thursday, early Friday, and moving well inland. If you remember earlier this morning, southeast Louisiana was still within the cone of uncertainty. Now it's not even close. As a matter of fact, the western edge of the cone only goes about as far as Apalachicola, Florida, Mexico Beach, same areas of Hurricane Michael. So this looks like it is going to stay well away from us. We have a cold front on the way for tomorrow. Not really doing much to our temperatures, but the drier